Are Supreme Court rulings negotiable?
I think in life, certain situations do crop up which look for at least a re-examination of, you know, whether the... whether the ends are met and the means that are used to achieve that ends are justified.
I'm sure you can't have chief ministers or who, I mean, or whichever head of local government authority creating ordinances every time a Supreme Court passes a judgment which might seem unfavorable.
Well, what happened to the dance bar? How did that happen?
Okay, yeah.
And that's a classic case and it's happened so recently. Hmm. How have they reversed the dance bar order? Supreme Court has ordered it.
Okay, so but even that had to be done at a certain time but hasn't been done, isn't it?
Yeah, but they are contemplating. In our case, it was a clear cut out. No, your building goes. Period. Yeah. There is no sympathy for you. You've got nothing back in return. And also, you see, what hurt us most was that the judge tied the hands of the bureaucracy and the politicians and said no one must interfere or in the implementation of this order.
Mm. To what extent does a Supreme Court's order run in its entirety, and to what extent does someone have an ability to counter it in some way, you know, go to a president, ask for a larger bench, ask for some curative petitions and so on?
When the Supreme Court passes law, it is the law. In fact, if you would see that in the middle of September last year, when they had actually taken suo motu cognizance that since people weren't out, they extended the duration for 5 months so the people could actually come out. So they have actually tried to do whatever the best they could have. But taking that out of the picture, when a Supreme Court has already passed an order, it has to be demolished, it has to be demolished. Though I understand, I have seen it was the residence, but in fact it's now be declared illegal. Now, you can, you know, have your own way with it. You might not agree with it, but you have to follow it. It's the word of the law.
Chapakola compound case, without getting into the exact specifics of which building should stay and which building should not, ultimately, the parties have themselves come to court. It is not as if the court on its own motion decided take this or take that out. The Residents Association here itself came to court saying, please regularize us. Court said, no, sorry, we can't. And whatever the order the court has passed, in terms of which part has to be demolished, that is final. You can ask for a modification, but the court has, and nobody has, as far as I know, as far as I can make out, nobody has asked for this modification. Nobody has asked for this clarification. And even the last option of the curative petition has been foreclosed. So you may disagree, you may find it incongruous, you may find it difficult to enforce, it may be very hard. But at the end of the day, when the court says, do this, you have to do this. And it's not a matter of whether the court was right or wrong. That question is closed now. Once the court has passed its judgment, that is right. And because the Supreme Court is final, it is right. So that's the end of the matter.